top story. She stood face to face in court with the three people who murdered her mother.
Robin Brule says her mother, a retired Albuquerque teacher, was visiting a friend in Arizona when the killers broke into her friend's home. Today, more than 3 years after the murders, Brule spoke with News 13's Marissa Lucetto. Marissa?
Dean, Jess, Brule says she doesn't want her mother to be remembered as a victim. She wants her known as a loving mother, grandmother, and friend.
Beauty, humanity, resilience, strength, perseverance, and choice.
Those are the words that make Robin Brule smile and think about her mother.
Those are the things she always taught us.
And everything the 75-year-old embodied until the day her life was taken.
She thought that kids were the most amazing things and that they deserved every opportunity.
Ruth Schwed was a school teacher for 30 years, an avid traveler.
She loved nature. She thought it was so beautiful. She wanted to be out in nature as much as possible.
But most of all, Schwed knew how to be a friend.
Barb Leslie, whose house she was at, had recently lost her husband, and my mom had experienced the loss of my dad, and she knew how hard that was and wanted to encourage Barb and be with her.
And that's what she did. Schwed packed up in February 2016 and left to spend a few weeks with longtime friend Barbara Leslie in Arizona. Brule says it wasn't like her mother not to stay in touch when she was away. So after not hearing from her for a day, Brule called police.
She didn't check in with either me, my brother, or my sister.
Arizona police would find the two women shot to death in Leslie's home during a home burglary, all for a few credit cards.
This was so unnecessary, so senseless, so cowardly.
Police ultimately arrested three suspects in the case. 3 years later, all three have been convicted of murdering the two women. When asked if Brule has found forgiveness, she says only one word comes to mind: choice.
They had choices about their lives. They had choices about what they could do. They had choices about what they needed to do to get money. And they chose to enter into a home and murder two defenseless elderly women.
While the family continues to heal, Brule says she's reminded of her mother every day.
She would want us to be happy and joyful and to be giving back to our community. And so that's what I try to remember, and that's what I try to live every day as a testament to her.
Brule is now part of a nonprofit known as Every Town for Gun Safety, which advocates for gun control legislation. And through this, she's also able to share her mother's story. Back to you, Jess.
All right. Thank you, Marissa. One of the three killers in the case was sentenced to in 2017 to life in prison for the murders. The other two will be sentenced in April.